I'm sitting up here telling you I'm not an expert on your team. You know, I'm watching you from the sidelines, and I've watched most of you in high school. I've seen most of you play in college. That doesn't make me an expert on it. The experts on your team are right here, and that's something I think you need to keep in mind throughout the course of the year. You have a chance to do something historic in this game this year. Not good. Not really. You have a chance to make history. And other teams do too. But you have an extraordinary opportunity to do that. You have, as Coach said, you have the talent and experience, and watching you play, you guys seem to really get along well and seem to have really, really good guys out there on and off the floor. So what can stop you from accomplishing what your goals are? And it's a lack of togetherness. And I think you have to be really tough-minded and mentally tough to stay together throughout the course of a difficult season. And you have, truthfully, more obstacles than most teams have because of the spotlight that's on you. Every camera is on you. Throughout the course of the year with the coverage now, you're going to be talked about as much, if not more, than any team in the country, and arguably any team in the last 20 years. As your season goes along, there are going to be people like me in my job that we're going to talk about at the start of the year. We're going to talk about how good you can be. Then we're going to talk about how good you are. Then people are going to get bored with that. And we're going to start talking about how can you beat Kentucky. All right? Then they're going to start talking about what are their weaknesses. And they're going to start hammering, instead of what you're really good at, they're going to start hammering, and we will start hammering little things maybe that are maybe we see a crack here or there that may exist, may not. And we'll start talking about that stuff. And then we'll start talking about your lineups. Should so-and-so be playing ahead of so-and-so? Or is this guy getting too many minutes? Should this guy be playing the three or the two? Or is this guy good enough to play this spot? Or who's better than who? And we're going to be armchair quarterbacks and start talking about your team when the truth is we don't know. We think that's fine. We all have opinions. There's nothing wrong with that. But we don't know. The people who know are in here. And keeping that at the forefront of your mind is a big deal. So there are going to be, those are things that can divide you. When you start counting minutes instead of paying attention to productivity in those minutes, that's something that can divide you. Now, if you're tough enough as a group that you can lay it all on the line in practice, and you can compete your tails off and fight each other for time, fight each other for the ball, fight each other to win, in practice, in drill, everything, fight to the tooth and nail, and then when practice is over, you guys unite as one and move forward together as one, that takes a tough group to do that. With this group, nobody will care at the end of the year who played, how many minutes you played, how many points you scored. They're going to look upon you as, were you a champion? Were you a winner in that way? You know, did you do the special thing that you can only accomplish together?